game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
All right, welcome back from that short break in case you're just joining us. Welcome to the show. But do remember, guys, we don't want to hear from you. We want to keep the conversation going. So engage with us on our social media platforms, Facebook pages, Urban Television, Twitter. The handle is at Urban TV Uganda. And certainly the big discussion for the rest of the show in just a bit. We'll jump into the English Premier League. And the question is very simple. Who do you think will come out on top in the crunch tie that does get to see the Premier League? The project restart takes center stage this evening. Manchester City at the Etihad. Do get to welcome Arsenal. Feel free, head down to social media and keep the conversation going. But in the meantime, first things first, let's look at a couple of results from the games that were played yesterday. That is down in Germany. That is actually in Spain, because the Spanish La Liga as well. I did have a bit of football that did happen to go down, including for the club side that happens to be Barcelona. They are now 5 points clear at the top of the summit. They managed to put two goals past Leganes in a game where Ansu Fati and definitely Lionel Messi had scored the two goals on the night. For Getafe, they were held to a goalless draw against Espanyol. Meanwhile, at home for Villarreal, they had a 1-0 win against a Mallorca side that have struggled. And definitely, those were some of the games that did get happen. Sharon, for Barcelona now, it's more pressure being piled on Real Madrid, because tomorrow Real Madrid faces Valencia. That will be at the Santiago Bernabeu. But even then, you look at this Barcelona team. Ansu Fati, I remember when he first debuted, which was their season at the age of 16. He was the second youngest player to be able to play for the senior team. And as it is right about now, he continues to score goals, 5 goals for himself this particular campaign. Some look at him as one of the big prospects going forward. And then for Messi, hitting a milestone, 699 goals, both for club and country as well, among so many other different talking points that did happen in the game last night.
Is he Nigerian?
He's actually
from
Guinea-Bissau.
Yes, yes. I think he must be a very lucky boy, because remember they shifted with his family to Barcelona or to Spain in 2012. And immediately he joined the Academy of Barcelona, which has really worked for him so well. And I now begin seeing probably there is a replacement of Lionel Messi coming on in the subsequent years to come, because all along we've been asking ourselves, we've been seeing Barcelona has been having a culture of promoting players right from their academy up to the senior team, which of the time, I think two seasons ago, they were going against the norm. But I think they are beginning to realize that there's need for them to go back to that traditional way of doing things or promoting. So you can see that gentleman doing some wonderful stuff there. So for me, I think Lionel Messi should be very happy that maybe with time, he could be, of course, he might not play exactly the kind of style of play that Lionel Messi plays. But at least when he talks about scoring goals, because having 5 goals in the senior team and looking at how many games he has played, ideally for me, I think he has a very good chance of making it through. Because if you also look at the age that Messi broke through the national team, the senior team, I think was also at the age of 16, around 16, 17 there. So almost at that same age. And then for Messi himself, Messi still continues putting ice on the cake, clearly showing people that, yes, I am Messi, they're great.
Okay.
So
a very interesting penalty subject to debate on whether or not it should have actually been awarded in the first place. But for Messi, he didn't have any of that. His business was putting it behind the back of the net. For Kiki Setien, though, he knows very well that his primary target now is going to be picking up that La Liga trophy, because they know Barcelona is, Real Madrid is within sight. They're looking to chase them down for the rest of the campaign. How competitive is it going to be in Spain? Both for the battle for the title, the Champions League, but certainly for the bottom sides as well.
Well, you see, before I talk about the competitiveness, I think one thing that we are facing right now is the absence of VAR. That's where there could be a lot of those controversies of whether that should have been a spot kick or not a spot kick taken from the penalty area. So it's kind of a little bit hard, but of course, you know, they normally say the big man or the big woman, the referee, takes the day. If there's a decision within, then it's fine. But I'm still looking at the competition between Real Madrid and Barcelona. For me, I think Madrid is also not seated, because Villarreal, it's Villarreal they're facing. Valencia they're facing, sorry. If you look at the pedigree and the fact that Real Madrid is playing at Santiago Bernabeu, and basically, for me, I really feel Barcelona has should not get excited yet because apparently they're only 5 points different because they played one game ahead of Real Madrid. So for me, I think the gap is still very narrow and there's still a little bit of competition. However, what Real Madrid should do is that at Santiago they have all it takes. Okay. I mean, the boys are in very good shape. You really saw their first game, how they took it on. It was they were very comfortable as if they're playing with fans, much as that stadium is still into renovation. But I think for me, Barcelona should not sit down and think it's all done because I am having a feeling Madrid could actually shock them.
Okay, apologies. That game, though, is actually not happening at the Santiago, but actually at the Alfredo Di Stefano, which is the training ground, home to the Real Madrid B team in there. But that being said, let's quickly look at the table standings down in Spain as well and pretty much get a glimpse of how action is turning out as it is right about there. Barcelona are on 64 points. They happen to be 5 points clear of Real Madrid. Madrid have got that game in hand tomorrow for Sevilla. Meanwhile, they are currently third on 51 points. They are 4 points ahead of fourth place Real Sociedad. And then for Getafe, they are fifth on 47, a point ahead of sixth place Atletico Madrid. If Atletico Madrid win the game they've got today, they'll actually be stepping into the top four. For Villarreal, meanwhile, they are seventh on 44 points. Valencia are down in eighth on 43 points as it is right about the ninth place. You've got Granada, who are now 42 points. Atletico Bilbao are 10th on 38, three ahead of 11th placed Osasuna. Levante are 12th on 35, a point ahead of 13th placed Real Valladolid. And then at Real Betis, and then Real Valladolid are 14th on 32. Therefore, with Alaves, Aiba are hanging just outside the relegation zone. That is on 27 points in there as well. And then just outside the relegation zone, you've got Celta Vigo on 26, a point outside. And then Mallorca, Espanyol, and Leganes happen to be the three sides involved in the relegation dogfight that is happening down in Spain in there. Quickly, let's move on down in the English Premier League. There is a bit of football as well to fixtures look out for as the Project Restart Tech Centre, Aston Villa at 8 p.m. will be up against Sheffield United. And then for the side Manchester City, they'll actually be facing off against Arsenal. So those are the two games to look out for as the English Premier League does get to return later this evening. Obviously, we start with the game between Aston Villa and Sheffield United because if you look at Aston Villa, right in the relegation dogfight in the English Premier League, for their head coach, that is Dean Smith, he knows precisely what is at stake for the club because it's about survival. They take on a Sheffield United team that have been fantastic this particular campaign under Chris Wilder. The brand of football that they've actually been able to play, how organized they've been as a team. They don't have that many star players, but somehow they've managed to put the pieces together. And as we do speak right now, they're in the conversation for Champions League football. A win today for Sheffield sees them climbing into fifth place. How do you make of the game that kicks off Project Restart as the Premier League returns?
It's just going to be a very tight game for Aston Villa, surely. Because the fact that Aston Villa has had a very bad run this season. And then, of course, looking at where Sheffield United is. You know, the other day at the sports desk, I was making a joke with those of Diego. I'm like, I can't imagine Sheffield United is against Arsenal. I mean, one of the traditional teams you want to talk about in England. But hey, football is all about preparation. So how you prepare and how you plan best is what brings you food on the table or is what brings you success in the pitch, whatever, if you want to talk about it this that way. So for me, Aston Villa got to put something very tough because one, Sheffield United looks to be a little bit more solid when it comes to issues of defense also, and even the attacking apparently has improved a little bit. But again, the challenge would also be Brian. You know, it is going to be very hard for you to predict a game between Sheffield United and Aston Villa, basically because this is a Project Restart. All these people have been down, all the players have been down. We are starting like afresh, as if you're just restarting. So for me, it is going to be a very critical game, but more very critical on the side of Aston Villa, given the fact that Sheffield United really wants to see itself in the Champions League.
Obviously, for Aston Villa, they've got McGinn coming back, a fantastic creative player that they've got in the ranks. Much of the focus will be on the team captain, Jack Grealish, also happens to be a local lad from the city in there. He's been such a phenomenal player for them. You look at Sheffield, they are a very compact side defensively going forward. They attack as a pack, they defend as a pack as well. And, the question will be, can they keep it going into the new campaign? Because we've seen so many teams that come from the lower tier have an impressive first campaign, and you never know what happens to them in the second season.
Well, Sheffield United, I think if you look at the composition of their players and the kind of system they use, I have a feeling sometimes they use a 4-4-3. Or 4-4-2. You know, they keep on mixing like that. It's a blend of getting which team you're going to play. But Aston Villa has also been a very stubborn team of all the years. And you know, I have always seen with teams that are always fighting for relegation, especially in the English Premier League, has always given it so hard for the teams that are ahead of them. But so for Sheffield United, it has all it takes to shock Aston Villa at their own home.
Finally, the biggest game, it's Pep Guardiola versus Mikel Arteta, teacher versus student, master versus apprentice. And for Team Arsenal down in ninth place, but the conversation for Champions League football for so many of the fans, how realistic that is, it's a whole different conversation. For Man City, Guardiola is saying they'll be using all the 5 substitutions because their target at the same time is to come out and compete when the Champions League is back. So he'll be looking to rotate the team, keep the players fully fit. He also says when David Silva pretty much is ready to go, they'll offer him a big farewell, especially when the fans are able to return. But ultimately, Roy Sane is back for Man City. For Arsenal, they've got most of the players coming back from injury as well. So both coaches have fully fit squads to choose from.
It's quite very unfortunate. I know, okay, they have all very fully fit players who have come back, yes? If you look at the side of Arsenal, a lot of positive news in the camp coming out is that Aubameyang could be signing the contract. That is if they keep in the conversation quite so well, because even the player himself, when he was having an interview with one media house in France, he put it very clear, he's happy if only the club can sit down and discuss everything. So it is also a motivating factor for the players in the camp, because remember, he's a team captain and also being a top scorer in the league apparently, so you don't want to take away that fact. But I have so many reservations, because the statement came 2 days ago. Arteta is saying he wants to use players. He wants to give these young players a chance to also play in the remaining games. And yeah, you're going to face a team like Manchester City, which is very aggressive, pedigree-wise. And this is a guy, you've been his assistant, so he knows your weaknesses in and out. So for me, I think it's going to be a very, very slim chance for Arsenal to really win at Etihad.
All right, for Manchester City, they'll be going for the 7th consecutive win. When they've actually played against Arsenal, they've been totally dominant in the recent couple of years. They'll be hoping that run can actually continue. Meanwhile, as the English Premier League gets returned, all the games are going to be played behind closed doors, which means that for the fans, they'll definitely be left out to watch the games back home. But definitely on top of that, I do understand that for the Premier League players, the back of the shirts are going to have Black Lives Matter statement at simply join the fight against racism. And then there'll be a hard badge that is right at the front of the jerseys to stand with the NHS, which is the health community that have led the journey when it comes to the fight against the pandemic, which is COVID-19. Say, Project Restart kicks off today, and certainly should be some exciting football for most of the fans. That being said, that brings us to the end of the show. Tomorrow, the entire team of Sportswoman should be here, and then we'll be back for Friday. That is on Game On Fan Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon. This was a fantastic sporting evening, and it's definitely a wrap.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.